Welcome to another episode of At the Table with Patrick Lencioni, where everything we talk about is related to changing the world of work so that more organizations can be more effective and less dysfunctional, and employees can be more fulfilled and less miserable. I'm your host, Pat Lencioni, and I'm joined, as always, by Cody Thompson, my co-host. What's your word today, Cody? How you doing?
I'm doing really well.
Really well? That works. We've got the co-founder of The Table Group, Amy Hyatt, with us.
Hi, guys.
Hello. Hey. And we've got our engineer, Matt, back.
I am a little nervous.
Matt Lencioni, he's not on mic. Hello, Matt. It's good to have you here. Today, Cody, what are we going to talk about?
The topic is, so you want to fire someone.
So you want to fire someone. We've been trying to do this podcast for a couple weeks. It's been really busy. I can't wait to talk about this.
Yeah.
Because we've had some amazing experiences with clients recently. And this is one of the biggest things that excites me in terms of our ability to do good for other people in the world by understanding the right way to fire people and the right reason to fire people and the reason not to fire people.
Absolutely.
And so here's our first piece of advice. So you're thinking about firing somebody, stop. Don't do it. Because if you do it for the wrong reason, it is the worst thing in the world. It's terrible for that person. It's terrible for your organization. And it's terrible for you because someday you're going to realize that. It's a horrible thing. And if you don't fire somebody and you realize later that you made the right decision, it's the best thing ever because it's good for that person. It's good for your organization. And you feel like it's such a gift. It's like going through the garbage because you lost something and finding $1,000. What a gift it is when you don't fire somebody and you realize everything turned out better. So what we're going to say is if at all possible, don't fire that person. But if it's the right thing to do, then it's the right thing to do. We're going to help people today figure out how to make that decision.
Right. And I'll say this, like to contextualize where this podcast would fall in that process is you talk about, hey, listen, if you haven't done everything you possibly can to coach this person, if it's a behavioral thing or a way they're showing up, if you have not constantly reminded them, this right. podcast comes way later than that. This yeah. is like the last part of the whole process. But when you say, you know, I love when you say like firing someone is the last act of cowardice for not being willing to have difficult conversations or hold them accountable prior to.
Exactly. And we're going to talk later today. Firing is often a problem with hiring.
Yep.
And that's your fault or our fault. And so, yes.
No, just them. No,
yeah. And so that's what we want to do is we want to make sure if you're going to do it, you're going to do it well, and it's going to be good for everyone. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it is. And sometimes it is necessary, but there's ways to do it and ways not to do it. This might be in some ways the most important podcast we've done because it's so practical. We were just talking to somebody who said, I think I'm going to go fire some of my people. I wonder if I should do the working genius before I do that. And Matt was like, absolutely.
Well, and you have to assume, and this is something that is hard for me, but I've seen it over and over again. You have to assume that you can remedy the situation. Like if you go into it, like with a belief that things can change, you'll be much better off as you get this process started.
Yes. And it's always better to err on the side of grace.
Exactly.
And to wait until you know for sure. Now, there are plenty of people out there that don't fire somebody even long after right. they know it was the right thing. Mm-hmm. That's a terrible idea. What we're saying is if you're not sure, if you're not clear, then do try everything you can to avoid it. But once you know it's not good for them, it's not good for you, it's not good for the organization, waiting is a really bad thing.
Yes. Right.
And I think that's what this podcast hopes to accomplish is like, instead of stringing this out over months and weeks to figure out what is the criteria, like giving people some real tangible tools to say, hey, what does that look like? How could I get there faster to know for sure if it is a one that I should move out or a person that we need to change or reorient in a different way.
Absolutely. And so the first thing, the first question, if you're thinking like, gosh, maybe I should fire this person, the first thing you should do is consider this, say, are they a cultural fit? And that sounds very amorphous, but do they fit the company's values? And if they do, now, first of all, to even ask that question, you have to know what your company's values are and they have to be real. So some people are like, I don't know. Well, I'm not sure what our values are. Then it's a crapshoot. But if you know, like our company is generally about these certain things, if they fit those values, do not fire them.
Yep.
And we've had people go, oh, they're a cultural fit, but you know, I just don't. And it's like, don't fire them. Firing a person who fits your company values sends a horrible message to that person, to the rest of your organization. And it says to you that you don't really believe in what you're saying.
Yeah. I love that.
You're actually making me feel better because I've been going through something in my mind this whole time. You guys have been talking of the one person that I let go years ago. I can't even use the word fire because it feels too...
Oh, you fired her.
That's how we brought you on the podcast. Yeah. You have so many notches on your belt. We figured that you... No, you have one.
No, but I was like, did I do everything I could? Probably not. But then when you talk about the values thing, I'm like, oh yeah, there was a reason that that had to happen.
I remember you were absolutely certain there was no way she could make it.
Right. But I still, to this day, I'm like, should I have done more?
Well, better to ask that question. Right. I can say this, wherever she is, she's better.
Yes.
Because it wasn't going to work well.
Right. Right.
It wasn't going to work well.
Well, and that's why I like what you said, Pat, is like, if they fit your values, don't. And that's sort of unequivocally, you know, that's kind of jarring right. to hear, right? But it's true. What tends to happen is either, oh man, well, they'd fit our values, but maybe they're in the wrong, you know, we're not getting enough out of them, or maybe we don't know where to put them, and we'll talk about that. But the other thing is true too, is oftentimes people go, well, this person doesn't fit our values, but they get a heck of a lot of work done, so let's keep them. So you're sending the wrong message
right. either way. Ways,
right. You
know? And Amy, in your case, we can go back and this person does not listen to this. There's 1,000% certainty. Yeah. But she was neither hungry nor emotionally intelligent.
Exactly.
She yes. may have been humble. She was a sweetheart, mm-hmm. but she was so out of her element. She was unhappy. Every day was really unpleasant.
It was a battle.
You knew that.
Right. Now, yes.
And we could go back and say, did we rip the Band-Aid off a little too quickly or too slowly? There's plenty of room for that. And you got to pray for that person right. and have grace. But she was never going to fit into our culture.
I at the time, I thought I was setting her free.
And you were.
And you were, yeah. And that's why, so your first point, Pat, I mean, this is why it's so important that companies have cultures and not just words on a wall somewhere, is that you just used this example and said, we know what our values are, humble, hungry, and smart. And when you can just quickly go, oh yeah, this person didn't fit in there. There's another place for them to fit. This is going to be painful for them to stay here. But it's predicated on the idea that it's not 7 words that are on your elevator when you go up and down that you right. go, hey, should I fire this person? Let me go to the elevator and check which of these boxes they hit. It's that it requires that you have a real culture.
Right.
And too many companies don't have a real culture, and hiring, firings feels like a flippant sort of ad hoc decision. And if you have a real culture, it actually gets so easy and so clear that even years later, Amy can go, yeah, that was the right thing. Yep. Seemed very obvious.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then it goes back to the question of hiring and, you know,
exactly.
It's how much pain are you in? How quickly do you do it? Did we follow our own rules in hiring someone? Probably not. Like there's been times when we jump the gun a little. Unlike Cody, who we made interview like 7 times. Like,
yeah, what's the deal? What were you worried about? No, I'm just kidding.
It's true, though. And, yeah. and to punish someone else for making a hiring mistake, mm-hmm. and by punish, I don't mean letting them go, but I mean like making them feel rejected and doing it in a way that doesn't respect their dignity or doesn't give them any time and energy to figure it out. Mm-hmm. To just go, we made a hiring mistake, now we're going to fire you. You just hurt them twice.
Right. Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean you should keep them, but it means give them grace, help them figure out their next thing, help them understand that it was your fault, help them understand how to make sure the next job is great, love them through the fact that they're not a cultural fit without saying you're a bad person right. or you're just not good enough for
right.
us.
Right.
It sounds crazy, but it's really helpful.
And that's what's great about the fact that companies have different cultures, because there's another company that person would thrive in. It just doesn't happen to be this company. You know what I mean? So that's the point.
Early in our company's history, we almost hired somebody. Do you remember that, Amy?
Oh, I sure do.
And we just had this gut feel she wasn't going to work out. And yet we said to her, this isn't going to be good for you here, but you're awesome. And we helped her, and she got a job at a company, and she did great and still likes us. Mm-hmm. And though we rejected her from working with us, it wasn't because she was a bad person. It was just she would not have fit.
Right.
She would not have
result,
fit.
As a result, she's still a fan.
Yep. And that's the great thing. We talked about this, Cody, before too, is you should be able to let someone go in such a way that they go, that was the best gift that anybody gave me. I like those people.
Yeah.
Not like they betrayed me.
Totally. It almost like in the relationship analogy, every firing should be this, hey, you're not the right person for me and I'm not the right person for you. So let's go find the right people for each other, and not a, let's throw people's stuff on the lawn and say, get out of here. Good luck to you. That's possible. If you do it this way,
yep.
It is possible.
Absolutely. It's like being in college and after your first year of college going, hey, you know, you're a great guy, but I don't want to room with you. Mm-hmm. And that's okay. And let's, you know, who'd be a great roommate for you is this person.
Yep.
And that can be great. Okay. Cultural fit. Huge, huge, huge. The first barrier you should pass through. So let's just say you look and you go, yeah, they are a culture. Oh, by the way, I'm going to use an example for me. I worked at a company, I almost said the name of the word, a big software company, and I was not a cultural fit. I mean, not a culture fit. In fact, I got hired by people who knew I wasn't a cultural fit. They didn't particularly like the culture either. So they actually taught me how to interview to get through it without letting people know I wasn't a cultural fit.
You snuck in.
Yeah.
And that probably wasn't good.
No, you know? They were like, here, when they ask you this question, answer this, yeah. Answer this, answer this. And I was like, thank you. Woo, I'm in. But then I had to work there.
Yeah.
It's like going on a date and pretending you're something you're not. It's like you're actually
trying to... I love the opera. Then you have to go to the opera.
Oh, yeah. No, back to my backpacking example when I called Rich. So I was like, I love backpacking. He's like, I don't think you do.
So the thing about it is like, it would have been a gift for me for that company to come along and go, hey, you know something? We're really uber competitive and kind of political here. That's kind of how we are. It's the founder is like that. We should make t-shirts that say that. You're not like that. It'd probably be best for you if you went someplace else because it's going to suck working here for you. Mm-hmm. But people don't do that.
You're trying to find a match.
Exactly. So cultural fit is the first pass. So let's just say you go, oh, well, this person is a cultural fit. Do not fire them. Go to the next thing and say, let's look at their, are they a fit for the role they have? And this is working genius. Mm-hmm. Are the things they're doing lining up with the things they're awesome at that give them joy and energy? Sometimes a person, as they fit the culture, they're in the wrong job. They're miserable. They're making me miserable, but not because of who they are as a person, but because of what I'm asking them to do.
Right. They're fighting against their geniuses all day.
Yeah. And we had recently one of the classic stories. We've all heard these stories before, right? The curator of a zoo, you know, the classic zoo curator story that we met a guy who runs a zoo. And he had somebody that worked for him who wasn't very good with the animals. They were about to fire him. The guy loved animals, but he had no connection with the animals. So he goes, we were about to fire the guy. They did his working genius. This guy said, there's certain working geniuses you have in order for animals to trust you. Interestingly enough, it has to do with discernment. It's like this instinct. Animals know when you get them. This guy had none of that.
Yeah.
Right. He couldn't build a rapport with the animals. He was frustrated. They were frustrated with him. The animals must have been frustrated with him. They were going to fire him. They figured out what his working genius was. And they said, you're going to work and you're going to build the facilities for these animals because you love them, but they just don't relate to you. But you can serve them. The guy is now really happy in his job. He didn't get fired. He didn't get rejected. The people that work with him love him. They just know what his skills are.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And this guy was on the moon because he thought he was going to crush this guy. And now he's actually putting him to use. He's valuable. He's happy. They're happy. They avoided doing something really bad.
That would have been a tragedy.
Yeah.
Lose someone that was a cultural fit that just wasn't in the right job.
Yep.
And it speaks to the thing that you said at the very beginning, which is like, this is the best feeling in the world is going from, oh no, I have to let this person go to, oh, wow, we moved them into a role that better suits them. They're a cultural fit, and now they're contributing in a way that they never have before. This is a 1+1=5 situation.
You know what happened 2 weeks later? You were there for this, right, Amy? When the guy started to tell the story, I thought he was telling the same story to a bunch of people. And he was saying, so I had this guy that worked for me at the zoo, and he struggled in this area. And I said, yeah, you told us this 2 weeks ago. He goes, oh, no, this is a totally different story.
Yeah.
Another guy.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah, you might not know this.
Yeah, I didn't realize that because I wasn't on the first call.
In a totally different scenario, for different reasons, he had another guy that they changed his job. They were about to lose him. He goes, two of my employees I was going to fire. Both of them, by the way, you know what they did? They turned a guy that worked with animals into a guy who consults to people that work with animals. Mm-hmm. He's going to be the employee of the month at the zoo.
Yeah.
The guy's bouncing off the walls. He was about to get fired.
Wow.
So figure out if they're a fit for their role.
That's a dramatic change.
Yeah.
And it's possible. That's what I want the listeners to hear. Like, it can change.
Yep.
Happens. It can be different.
All
it does.
The time. So let me tell you this story. For me, when I should have got fired from a company for not being a role fit, And that was when I went to work in my first job after college, I was hired to do something that I thought sounded perfect for my personality. It was at a management consulting firm. I think I've talked about this. And I love managing people, that idea. And I love consulting, giving people advice. And they hired me to be a management consultant, but they really just wanted me to go into a room and quantify, do spreadsheets, mm-hmm. which I'm terrible at. Mm-hmm. Well, a bunch of my colleagues quit because it wasn't a role fit for them. But I didn't. We just thought, oh, they just were too weak. And after 2 years there, one of the partners took me aside and said, this isn't a good job for you. And I was like, oh, I was just desperate to fit in. And mm-hmm. she said, you'd be a good partner because you understand the big picture, but this detail stuff you're doing, it's not good for you. And at the time I felt terrible. When I finally figured out my working genius, I was like, crap, had they done that in my third week at the company, that would have been a gift.
Well, and it's totally true. What's so interesting is somehow we have this world of work where it feels like you have to, like that company was like, well, if they don't burn out as this, they'll eventually, you know, the good ones will rise to the top or whatever, and we can hire partners. That's the opposite of what you should do, because the right ones leave and the wrong ones stay. And then too often, like people who are really great individual contributors on a team get promoted to a manager without any thought of like, does that suit them? And then they struggle at the manager role. And it's like, this helps explain it. What are they great at?
And you know what's funny? I should go back there to that company. It's still around, and talk to them about this, because what they did is they went out and hired 18 people that were the most excellent people they could find. And so I slipped through there. I'll be self-deprecating. Somehow I was a good interview. Okay. They knew that 14 of those people were probably going to wash out eventually.
Yep. And they probably have a spreadsheet explaining that's what happened.
What they didn't realize though is 12 of those 14 were going to leave with horrible confidence problems. One of my good friends, you guys all know him, who's one of the smartest people I know, got crushed there. Mm-hmm. And they were like, oh, well.
And he's like, literally a rocket scientist.
Yes. And he got crushed there. But they were like, well, that's how it works. It's like, no, you could have actually seen this coming.
Totally.
You could have hired 18 people or actually you could have hired 10 people and 8 of them would have worked out well. And the other 2 would have been explained, here's why it didn't work out. They just said, we'll hire these people. They all have high self-esteem. They'll leave with low self-esteem, but we'll find the 4 or 6 people we need.
And it was worth it.
Yeah. And there's a bunch of therapists in the world that are glad that they do that.
Exactly.
That's how they're getting by. But so the first thing is cultural fit. The second thing is, do they fit the role? And if they don't, find a role that fits them. But there's a lot of people listening to this who are saying, but what if I don't have a role for them? What if I figure out what their talents are? We don't have the job for them here. And if you're in a small company, you just don't get to make up jobs.
Right. But what you can do at a small company is not every role is like we do this here all the time. We're constantly changing our duties based on our skills and geniuses.
And right. What we have going on.
Right. Yeah. And what we have going on. So you can be flexible. It's like customer service rep doesn't mean the same thing depending on the person.
Exactly.
If that makes sense.
Oh, absolutely. We had that go on here.
Right.
But there are those companies that go, oh my gosh, you're one of those. We don't have any open jobs. We need that job filled. We've really shuffled everything around. I just don't think we have a need for you right
yes,
now.
Yes, yes. That's
so
true.
What do you do then? You fire them. No, you say to them, we are not rejecting you because you're not a values fit. We're not even rejecting you. We're saying you deserve to be in a job where you add value. It's not here right now. Mm-hmm. If things changed, we would be glad to have you here and let you do that. Let's help you figure out where you can really be put to good use so that you feel good about yourself and other people do, and so that you know that we care about you. I mean, that sounds crazy, and some people go, oh, we don't have time for that. Oh, you absolutely have time for that, because doing it any other way leaves that person to go out in the world feeling bad and to tell other people how this company crushed them.
Totally.
To the extent you can preserve a person's dignity in the process will benefit you and them.
Well, and then the other people who work there see what happened.
Survivor guilt. Right?
That's actually the word that came to mind, Amy, was this is a common theme. And I, as we're having this discussion, I'm like, yeah, this is about, we believe that work should be dignifying. Mm-hmm. If you're a cultural fit and there's no role fit for you, then we should find a place where you would be dignified and we can help you do that. And it does come down to the people who say, we don't have time for that. And then they throw people's stuff on the lawn and say, get out in the relationship. It's also a recruitment thing. I mean, that person's going to go out and say, hey, you don't want to be at that company because they were really not gracious as I left, you know, versus
Absolutely.
Taking 10 minutes, you know, or a couple of days to help them find the right fit or to have the right conversations. And then they go out in the world and they're like, yeah, that's a great company. You know, it wasn't the right fit for me, but knowing what I know about you, you should probably work there. You know, like they could use you and you look like a cultural fit.
People do it that all the
totally
time.
It just totally changes the whole nature of the conversation.
That's funny you say that, because if somebody came to me and they were graduating college and they had a job offer at the company that I went to that I didn't fit, I would say, tell me something. I'd give them the working genius and I'd ask them questions and I'd go, oh, you're going to love it there.
Right.
Or like, no. I mean, a guy that works here was getting ready to go to law school. Mm-hmm. And he was sitting down to do his first day of LSATs preparation. And I knew his working genius. I said, why are you going to law school? He goes, well, my grandfather went to law school. You know, my dad went to law school. I said, I don't think I've ever met anybody with your profile that loved being a lawyer or going to law school. And he stopped. And he said to me, oh my gosh, that was going
to
be
just waiting for someone to say that to him.
Exactly. And so we can do that in those jobs. Now let's say this, your person is struggling. They're a cultural fit. They're in the right role, but they're still struggling. Now you got to look at the environment. Like, are they being managed well? Is there something in the environment that's not allowing them to feel really good in that? But it's the right answer is never to fire somebody that's a cultural fit and has a job that taps into their skills. There's something else going on that you need to help them discover. Now, let's say that somebody is definitely not a cultural fit, or you don't have the role for them and they have the right manager and all that stuff. The best way to help them move on is to just say to them, I want you to be happy. Mm-hmm. And I want you to work with people that are really happy with what you're doing. Mm-hmm. How can we do that?
It's like painting the picture for them of what it could be like.
Exactly. More times than not, by far, they'll say, I don't think this is going to work. Mm-hmm. If you get a person to say that, you have won the firing lottery. Mm-hmm. Not because you don't have to pay severance or get a lawyer involved, but because you've actually preserved their dignity. Mm-hmm. Now you're their consultant.
You've helped them see it. Yeah.
And that is maybe, I can say as a leader, when that happens, it is one of the best things you can ever see, because you realize that you thought you were going to have to do something really cruel and you could actually do something kind. I will say this too, for all of us that have fired somebody for the wrong reason or in the wrong way, you will carry that with you forever.
Absolutely.
And not that you should do this well for yourself, but it's worth calling out the fact that it's no fun to know that you did that. Yeah. I suppose if we have, we should reach out to that person and say, you know, right, you're actually a good person, and I'm sorry that happened that way.
Right. Yeah. And nor should you punish yourself, because it's just a hard thing. But yeah.
When it's such an important conversation, because I think far too often in the workplace, and you imagine that people get fired because of they didn't hit their numbers, or that, you know, it's like all these other factors that don't even address any of these core issues. You know,
right,
are they a cultural fit? Don't fire them. Don't fire the people who are a cultural fit. Find a way.
You know, I know a professional football player who's in the Hall of Fame. I don't know that many of those, so don't be like, yeah, oh, one of my many friends. We were having beers the other day. But he's in the Hall of Fame, and he got fired, because everybody in football gets fired. The coach did not even call him. All he had to say is, you're awesome. They were friends. You're my friend. But you've lost a step. You cost a lot. There's probably another place that could use you, but for where we're heading right now, this isn't the right fit for you. You know what they did? They put a piece of tape on his locker saying, clear out your locker. Oh,
unbelievable.
My gosh. So if people at that level in such an obvious situation do that, think about the rest of us when we're, you know, in our workplace. So you want to fire someone? Stop.
Yeah.
Ask yourself these questions. Do something wonderful and heroic by saving them or by helping them exit for the right reasons with confidence, or check yourself so you know that you're doing it for the right reason and do it well.
And you mentioned, I love this, because hiring or firing is often a result of bad hiring.
Right.
And so like, if you find yourself too often firing people because they didn't fit, you have to go to the source too. You have to go to that might be a symptom of a larger problem.
Right.
Not knowing your culture, not hiring for culture, all of those things.
Do me a favor, everybody, if you're listening to this, please send us an email. If you can relate to this, or you have a great story about this, either way, we love to get that stuff back. It confirms for us what we're doing, and we can share that with others. It's a wonderful thing.
podcast@tablegroup.com.
Yeah, podcast@tablegroup.com. By the way, we should say something. We missed one last week.
Yeah.
And we just, we knew we were, we just had to go, couldn't get to it. So we'll try not to do that going forward. We'll try our very best. But thanks for your patience. We hope you enjoyed this. We'll talk to you next time on At the Table. God bless.